Before you understand the good news of the gospel, you have to understand the bad news of your sin. Think through the Ten Commandments and how they show you that you are a sinner before a holy God. The Ten Commandments have four commandments about how you've treated God, and they have six commandments about how you've treated others. Think through how you've treated others. One commandment is not to lie. How many lies have you told in your life? You cannot count them. Think through what God would call you on Judgment Day. He would call you a liar. Have you ever thought of yourself that way before? God tells the truth, and He would tell the truth to you. Many people say, I don't like it. I don't like the thought of considering myself as a liar. Well, in the Bible, God doesn't call you a liar so much as He does call you a snake in Romans 3. Think through how He says that the poison of asps is under your lips because of the deceit and the lies that you've told. The Ten Commandments reveal how we have dishonored God in adultery. God has said, you shall not commit adultery. And Jesus said in Matthew chapter 5, if you look at a woman to lust after her, you've already committed adultery with her in your heart. It's the thought that has caused you to break this commandment. God sees your thoughts. He sees your will. He sees your emotions. He sees your attitudes. And since you have broken this commandment of adultery, God would call you an adulterer of the heart. Another Ten Commandments is not to murder. And Jesus said in Matthew chapter 5, if you are angry with your brother without a cause, you are in danger of the judgment. And if you say, you fool, you are in danger of hellfire. He said that in light of the commandment not to murder. You've committed murder of the heart when you have been angry at someone, not been able to control your temper. Think through, in the eyes of God, you would be a liar, an adulterer of heart, a murderer of the heart. If you think through the evil murders that happen in our world, what's the first evil that God sees? When a murderer actually commits a horrendous crime, is it the plan? Is it the actual firing of the gun or stabbing of the knife? No, before all that, before the plan, before the actual horrendous event, the Lord sees the anger in the heart of the murderer. And that same anger has been in your heart. But how have you treated God? If you have treated others with anger, lust, and deceit, how have you treated God? Have you taken God's name, the name of the Lord of glory, and used it as a curse word saying, oh my, then you are a blasphemer. And all the time when you've broken all these commandments, you've broken the first commandment, to have no other gods. You have not loved God with all of your heart, all of your soul, all of your mind. You're an idolater. All of these sins rise up and cry out one thing, judgment.